This is going to be the second video about finding the sum of an arithmetic sequence. And I want to cover a couple of situations that we didn't see in the first video. So here's the first problem. Here I've got a sequence, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And of course I want to add them all up. So the first step would be to find out what the number of elements in the sequence is. And a mistake that's pretty easy to make would be to just subtract the first element, the 7, from the last one, 12, and we'd get a 5 and say, oh, so there's 5 elements or 5 terms in this sequence. But if we count them, or just look at this, it's pretty easy to see that there are really 6 terms. Well, here's what happens. When you subtract 7 from 12, it's as if you're kind of counting up from 7 but not including the 7. So if we count up from 7 and don't include the 7, we get 8 as 1, 9 is the second one, and then 10 is 3, 11 is 4, and 12 is 5. But we haven't counted the 7, which was the first term. So what we're going to do is we'll subtract the first term, the 7, from the 12, and that'll give us a 5, and then we're going to add 1. To make up for the fact that we didn't really count the 7. So now we've got the number of terms, which in fact is 6. So doing this before, I had this general formula, n over 2 times 1 plus n. And so 1 plus n, that's the next thing we have to change. 1 plus n was used because the first term was 1. Remember, in all the other examples, I was starting with 1, and going up, just counting upwards to however many terms there were, n terms. I'm going to have to change this formula slightly. Instead of saying 1 plus n, what I want to do now is have a formula that adds the first term and the last term, in this case the 7 and the 12. So I'm going to use I as the letter I use for the term. And the first term I'll call I sub 1. And the last term, I'm going to call I sub n, because, well, in this case, there are 6 terms, so I sub n would be I sub 6. So the n will still work here as a subscript. Okay, so let's plug the numbers into this new formula and make sure this all works. So the number of terms was 6, so my n over 2 is going to become 6 over 2. I sub 1, the first term, is a 7, and I sub n, the last term, is a 12. So I've got 6 halves times 7 plus 12. So let's see what happens. Well, 6 halves times 7 plus 12, 7 plus 12 is 19. And 6 halves, of course, is just 3. So I've got 3 times 19, and 3 times 19 is 57. And if you add up these 6 terms, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, you'll find that, in fact, they do add up to 57. Okay? So now another situation we have to deal with. Here I've got a sequence. 7, 10, 13, 16, 19. This is an arithmetic sequence because I have a common difference. I'm always adding 3 to a term in order to get the next term. 7 plus 3 is 10, 10 plus 3 is 13, and so on. So let's see how we deal with this. Well, once again, the situation is going to come, the problem is going to come when we have to deal with how many terms do we have. So if I take 7 and subtract it from 19, I'm going to get 12, and then if I added 1 to that, I'd get 13, but it's obvious that I don't have 13 terms here. In fact, all I've got is 5 terms. So what I have to do is this. Let's once again subtract 7 from 19, and I'll get 12. But remember, the common difference was 3. In other words, I was counting by 3s. So that means I'm going to have to divide by 3 to find out, to start finding out how many terms I have. So 7 from 19 was 12. If I divide that by 3, let's see, 12 divided by 3. That gives me a 4. And then I want to add 1 because I always have that first term that I'm not typically counting. So 4 plus 1. So n is 5. Okay, let's plug that into the formula we had. So this new formula was n, the number of terms, divided by 2, times the first term, which is 7, I sub 1, plus the last term, the I sub n term, which is 19. Okay, so the number of terms was 5, so n over 2 becomes 5 over 2. I sub 1 was 7, so that's 7 plus I sub n, 19. And let's see what we can turn this into. So that's going to be 5 halves times 7 plus 19 is 26. I think what I want to do is divide 2 into 26. So the 26 will now become a 13. I've got 5 times 13, which is 65. So the sum of these five numbers, 7, 10, 13, 16, and 19, is going to be 65. Okay? Now, let's put that all together into a problem with bigger numbers. So here I've got the sequence 50, 52, 54, and then it goes all the way up to 100. Okay, so how many terms do I have? Let's see. 50, my first term, subtracted from 100, my last term, is 50. And then since I'm counting by twos, my common difference is 2, I want to take that 50 and divide by 2. That'll give me 25. And then to find n, I'm going to add that 25 plus 1 for the first term, and n is going to be 26. Okay, so my formula was n over 2 times I sub 1 plus I sub n. N is 26, so that's 26 over 2 times I sub 1 is 50, and I sub n is 100. So let's see, 26 over 2 is 13, and 50 plus 100, well, of course, that's 150. And if you multiply 13 times 150, you'll get 1,950. You can check this if you want, but that's going to be the sum of all of the even numbers, starting with 50 and going up to 100. Okay, so let's just review this one more time quickly. To find the number of terms, we subtract the first term from the last term. Then we divide whatever we get by the common difference. In this case, I divided 50 by 2. And then we add 1 to that number because we haven't really counted the first term yet. Then we plug it into the formula, n over 2 times I sub 1 for the first term plus I sub n for the last term. Plug in all those numbers and we'll get the result. Okay, so that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.